Hari Om. We shall chant Gita Dhyanam, five verses, the first five verses and the last verse. Om Parthaya Pratibodhitam Bhagavata Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Gratitam Purana Munina Madhe Mahabharatam Advaitam Ritavarshinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim Ambatvamanusandadhami Bhagavad Gita Bhavadveshinim Namostute Vyasa Vishala Buddhe Fulla Ravindayata Patra Netra Yena Tvaya Bharata Taila Purnaha Prajvalito Jnanamaya Pradipaha Prapanna Parijataya Totra Vetraika Panaya Jnanamudraya Krishnaya Gita Amrita Duhe Namaha Sarvopanishado Gavo Dugdha Gopala Nandanaha Partho Vatsa Sudhir Bhokta Dugdham Gita Amritam Mahata Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kansa Chanuramardhanam Devake Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagad Gurum Yam Brahma Varunendra Rudra Marutaha Stunvanti Divyastavaihi Vedai Sangapadakramopanishadaihi Gayanti Yam Samagaha Dhyanavastita Tadgatena Manasa Pashyanti Yam Yogino Yasyantam Navidusura Suraganaha Devaya Tasmai Namaha Devaya Tasmai Namaha. We shall chant few verses from verse number 21, the second half. Arjuna Vacha Senayorubhayor Madhe Ratham Stapayamichyuta Yavadeta Niriksheham Yodhukaman Avasthitan Kairmaya Sahayodhavyam Asmin Rana Samudyame Yotsyamanana Veksheham Ya Etetra Samagataha Dhartarashtrasya Durbuddhehe Yuddhe Priyachikirshavaha So this first chapter of Bhagavad Gita is called Arjuna Vishad Yoga. It plays a very important role in the whole scheme of this Bhagavad Gita. From this first chapter, we understand exactly what was Arjuna's condition and problem. And it also shows that it is common to all. This first chapter shows us what is the meaning of this samsara and how we get caught up in samsara. It's a beautiful diagnosis of our human, you can say, condition. So Arjuna and the war is just an example taken here, but through that we can understand our life. Even if we take this war as symbolic, it is what is happening all the time, not only outside us, but within us also. Within us also there are all Pandavas and Kauravas all the time at war, trying to claim something. So there is this problem, what you call of samsara, which is nothing but sorrow, what you call grief. Then we have fear, we have pride, jealousies, and all of them gives rise to a lot of agitation, a lot of trouble to us. And we keep finding solutions for them in this world. Constantly we are struggling, our every action is to find some temporary relief from these problems of life. Because nobody wants to be in trouble, nobody wants to be sorrowful, nobody wants to be agitated. So we constantly try to find solutions for that. But whatever solutions we find, they're all temporary. They last for some time. It appears as though I have resolved all my issues, but before I know, some more issues prop up, like the tissue papers. If you remove one, then another one comes from the same place. So we have to understand exactly what is our problem, what is that which is causing us all this trouble. And that is what is done in this first chapter. First we will go through this whole first chapter, see what Arjuna is feeling, and then later on we will again go back and analyze it and understand how it is related to us also. See, there are these issues about dharma which becomes very complex to comprehend. There are three terms used regarding this dharma in Bhagavad Gita. One is, he calls swadharma. Swadharme nidhanam shreyah paradharmo bhayavah. Then Bhagavan also uses the term paradharma. And then he also uses the term adharma. Whenever there is adharma, rise in adharma and fall in dharma, I take avatar, Bhagavan says. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanamam adharmasya tadatmanam sujami aham. So swadharma is my dharma. Swa means me, I. Paradharma means somebody else's dharma. And adharma means nobody's dharma. It is nishiddha, wrong, papa. So here we have to, through Bhagavad Gita, we have to understand my dharma also. What is exactly my dharma? But to appreciate the dharma, I should be able to appreciate the goal of this dharma. Why we have to be dharmic? Why we should be good? Many times people, they say that, oh, be good. But why should we be good? Why not be bad? What is this logic about being good? There are so many people who seems to be so good, but they suffer. There are people who are seemingly so bad, but they have good time. So why should we be good? That is the one question which we should know. That will make us follow our dharma. Because in the world, many people talk about being good, being honest, being loyal. But what is the hetu? What is the cause? What is the purpose behind it? That should be understood properly. Then our goodness will be proper. See, just if suppose somebody is good out of fear, or somebody is good because he is getting something in return. Sometimes like salesperson and all, they are very nice, good, smiling and all. Because they want to sell you something. Maybe they want to sell you the vacuum cleaner or something. So, what is Swadharma? Then, what is Paradharma? There is confusion about this Paradharma also. Paradharma means somebody else's duties, somebody else's karma. Many people feel that we can do else's karma also, but that is also not allowed. Bhagavan says that is not proper. Many times parents, they try to do the karmas of their children. Homework diya hai school mein, pitaji baith ke likhte. Teacher asks, how can you commit so many mistakes? No, my father helped me. Father helped. That's paradharma. It's not your duty, it is somebody else's duty. And when we do it, what happens? Two things happen. One is that we are depriving that person from performing his own duty. And we are doing something wrong. So paradharma also have to be understood. And adharma also has to be understood properly. What is nishiddha, what is prohibited, what is wrong, what is papa. This concept of papa, adharma also can be appreciated if we can appreciate the ultimate goal. Otherwise it doesn't seem understandable. People don't understand why one should not do adharma. You see, if I can do adharma and nobody is bothered by that, then what is the problem? So all this we can understand. The diagnosis is beautifully done in this first chapter. Therefore it's very important. So Arjuna had understood his dharma properly. He knew, not only he, but all his brothers, they knew that this is a war which we have to fight to establish dharma as a last resort. It was not the first. So after trying Sam, Dan, Bheda, then finally this Danda Niti was followed. Arjuna came on the battlefield all prepared. Dhanurudhyamya Bharata. He had his dhanush in his hand and he was all prepared. And he requested Bhagavan to take his chariot in between the two armies. He said, why you want to go in between the two armies? He says, I want to see who have assembled here to fight with me. Kaihi maya saha yodhavyam asmin rana samudyame. That with whom should I fight, or who have assembled here to fight with me? So there was some sort of pride also in Arjuna. A lot of confidence was also there in him. And he was very, determined to start this war also. He was ready with his dhanush. And he requested Bhagavan to take his chariot in between the two armies. So he said that I want to see this Dhritarashtra's son, Duryodhana, who is the main actually cause to assemble all these people and to cause this fight. And Dhritarashtra also was involved in it. Dhritarashtra could have stopped him, could have stopped his son, but Dhritarashtra did not do it. Because of his own attachment, he also decided to follow this path of adharma. So Duryodhana is durbuddhehe. His buddhi is not proper. Buddhi helps us to discriminate, to distinguish between what is right and what is not right. Buddhi is our instrument which we have, where we can evaluate, we can judge, we can understand what is right, what is not right, what should be done, what should not be done. It helps us to analyze the whole situation. But buddhi can take proper decision and it can analyze things properly if there is good wisdom behind, good samskar, what you call in the chitta, if there are good information and data present, then the buddhi can take proper nirnay, can decide, yes, I have to switch off the phone. So this little decisions also we take with the help of our buddhi. But it should have good samskar to decide. Otherwise, out of arrogance or out of forgetfulness or out of pride or jealousy or selfishness or fear, we follow the path of adharma or paradharma. We want to give up what is my duty and do somebody else's duty, or follow the path of adharma out of all these negativities, not out of wisdom, not out of positive virtues, but out of all negativities, people tend to drop their dharma. So Arjuna had come here, but he had his own plus and minus points in his nature. So he said, I want to see. He had little anger also against all these Kauravas. How dare they insulted us? And they don't know. And they don't know with whom they have to fight. I am a great archer. I am the best. So in this way, he had his own little pride also. So when he requested Bhagavan to place his chariot in between the two armies, now Sanjaya, he is describing what happened. संजय उवाच एवमुक्तो ऋषिकेशः गुढाकेशेन भारत सेनयोरुभयोर्मध्ये स्थापयित्वा रथोत्तमम् भीष्मद्रोणप्रमुखतः सर्वेषां च महीक्षिताम् उवाच पार्थ पश्येतान् समवेतान् कुरुनिति एवमुक्तो ऋषिकेशः गुढाकेशेन भारत सेनयोरुभयोर्मध्ये भीष्मद्रोणप्रमुखतः सर्वेषां च महीक्षितान् संजय इज रिपोर्टिंग हियर टू धृतराष्ट्र. See, here we have in this chapter, Dhritarashtra spoke only one verse. Then Sanjaya spoke many verses. Then we have Duryodhana speaking in about 9 verses. And we also have Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, only half a verse, we will see. So Sanjay is reporting, he is saying that evam ukto Hrishikesha gudakeshena bharata. O Bharata, Bharata, he is addressing Dhritarashtra as Bharata. Ki when Gudakesh requested Hrishikesh, who are these two people? Hrishikesh is Bhagavan Krishna's name only. See here in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna is referred to or addressed with so many names. Rishikesh, Achyuta, Janardana, Later on also we'll say Deva Deva and so many, Mahabaho. Arjuna is also addressed in many, many different names. And all these names reveal certain characteristics of these great personalities. So here Rishikesh, is Bhagavan Sri Krishna, is Sakshat Ishvara only, who has taken avatar as Krishna. And the word Rishikesh means Rishika. Rishika means our senses. Senses are also called Rishikas. And Isha, Isha means the lord of the senses, the master of the senses. One meaning is one who had total control over his senses. And that is very important. Because senses, if they are under our control, then everything, our mind also comes under control, and the buddhi also comes under control. Senses are like the outer horses of the chariot of our body. So if the horses are stable, then the chariot also remains stable. So Rishikesh means the master of the one who has full control over his senses. But it also has a deeper meaning. Master of the senses means, what is that? Who is that? Who is the one who is really the master of our senses? See, senses themselves are inert, but the senses can function only if the mind is there behind them. Without the mind, without the antakarana, the senses cannot function. For example, you are sitting here looking at me, listening, but now and then, whenever your mind is running away from this place, you will not listen. Those things will go total blank like. Okay? Therefore, in between we crack jokes and then try to see how many of you are not laughing. So if you see that here others laughing, you also laugh. So without the mind, the senses will not function. But the mind itself will not function if one is not alive, if that prana is not there. And the prana itself will be not there if that pure consciousness, God, is not there within us. So God is the master of our senses, the ultimate, the supreme master. So Rishikesh is another name for Ishvara, who is the master of our senses, the supreme master. But now we feel we are the master. So Rishikesh, though Arjuna is ordering Bhagavan Krishna or requesting him to take his chariot, Arjuna seems to be the master here and Krishna is just a charioteer. But really speaking, Krishna is the master. In the state of ignorance, we think little topsy-turvy. We think we are the master and Ishvara is our servant or someone. Even when we go to temple or pray and all, we keep on ordering him, ye karo, wo karo, ye kaam karo, mera. Aapko maine nariyal to chadaya hai, phool bhi diya hai, ye kaam hona chahiye. Some people are quite strict about it. And they give what you call, they threaten also Bhagavan. Ki if you don't do this work, I will go to other gods. So you better for your own safety and own name and all. And I will tell everyone, Bhagavan itne kuch kaam nahi karne wale hai. So like that, we feel that Bhagavan is like some sort of shopkeeper, like we pay and he will do our work or something like that. In the state of ignorance, we feel that he is like that. I am the boss. That is what Arjuna also felt here. He is ordering, he is requesting, not ordering, but requesting, he had great love and respect. But still, he is requesting Bhagavan to take his chariot. But later on, after the whole Bhagavad Gita, he listens to the whole Gita, and finally he says, Ki karishye vachanam tava, oh my dear Bhagavan, I will do as you say. Here he is saying, you do as I say. But later on he tells him that I will do as you say. That is the transformation. In the state of ignorance, we say that, oh Bhagavan, you have to, I will plan my life, I will decide. by my own little buddhi, what is good for me, what is right, and then you do it according to my plan. I will give you the blueprint and you step by step just follow it. But instead of that, we should understand what is Bhagwan's plan, what is his will. That we can understand through the scriptures. What is his will for all human beings? What he wants us from us? And then we have to just follow it sincerely, with full faith. So Rishikesha is Bhagwan's name. And Gudhakesha is Arjuna's another name. Gudhaka Isha. One meaning is that one who had conquered sleep. See, for a great warrior also, they should have all mastery over their sleep. But another meaning of this Gudhakesh is that he had this ability. He had conquered as though darkness. He had the ability to use his weapons even in darkness. He had, just by listening, he could shoot the arrow on the target. So he had this great ability. He was a master archer, best student of Dronacharya. No doubt, great challenge for Arjuna was Karna. Karna was also quite fascinating and a great archer. And Karna could have even defeated Arjuna if Bhagavan Krishna was not there. And also, you know the story, Karna promises Kunti just before the war, all strategies, like Kunti goes and tells him how he was born and how he was the eldest of the Pandavas, of her sons. And that was a very shocking revelation for Karna. He was totally disturbed. That how come you are telling me now? You should have come before. Just before the war was to begin, she revealed this. It was very disturbing for him. And he just could not believe. But then he gives her a promise. That I promise that I will not kill your sons, but I will kill this Arjuna. Either Arjuna will die or I will die. You will totally have 5 children. So he gives the promise. And in during the war, he gets lot of opportunity to kill Yudhishthir, Bhima and all, but he doesn't touch them. He only fights with Arjuna and then finally gets killed. So Arjuna was a great warrior, no doubt. But all his greatness and all was also because of his great dedication and love for Bhagavan Sri Krishna. And Bhagavan Krishna was a great charioteer also. That many times he saved Arjuna by moving his chariot in a very beautiful way. Once Karna shot him and Bhagavan pressed the chariot down so that it went little down and the arrow went above him. So in this way, Arjuna is named here as Gudhakesh, master of sleep or master of darkness, who could fight even in darkness. So eva mukto rishikeshah gudhakeshena bharata. Till here everything is positive. The war is about to begin. Sena yor ubhayor madde stapayitva rathottamam, the best ratha. Best ratha, Bhagavan himself is sitting there in the ratha. Arjuna is there, that was placed in between the two armies. Sena yor ubhayor madde. Bhishma drona pramukataha. Bhagavan placed the chariot in such a way that Arjuna could see right in front of him Bhishma and Dronacharya. Now this was also very strategic for Bhagavan to do. Because Bhagavan wanted to convey to Arjuna the path of dharma also And he wanted to convey to Arjuna this great message or this great knowledge of that Brahma. So he wanted to make him as a nimitta so that this knowledge goes to all of us. It comes to all of us. Arjuna, as I said, he had come to this war, but he had lot of emotions and lot of other attitude in his heart. He had pride, he had anger, and he wanted to fight this war and win this war. He was personally connected to it. He felt that it is his personal insult that Draupadi was insulted and our kingdom is taken and my, and all this type of attitude was there in Arjuna's mind. If he had fought this war with this attitude, it wouldn't have been anything special. Because if suppose the other person is doing something in anger and I also do in anger, then it is same. Dharma cannot be followed with anger, with jealousy, with pride, with sense of taking revenge and all. Then it is not dharma. It's like a surgeon is operating on the patient. He cannot be like angry and kahan appendix bata de, nikal deta hu abhi usko, uski chutney banata hu, kiski appendix ki. He cannot be like this, because it is just a duty. You just take care of the health, because there is, should not be any anger, because you are not entitled to be angry like that. You have to just do your dharma. Even fighting this war, it is dharma without anger in the heart. Because it has to be done. Something has to be done, you do it. So it was very interesting. So Bhagavan wanted to bring out all this and wanted to give him the right message. So Arjuna was brought right in front of Bhishma Pitamaha and Dronacharya. Now these were the two people, he had great reverence for them. He was ready to give up his life for them. Bhishma Pitamaha had taken care of him right from his childhood. He was like great grandsire. And Bhishma Pitamaha also had great love and regard for all these Pandavas. Because of all circumstances and all, he was fighting against them. But he had great love and respect for them. In one of the versions of Mahabharata, it is said that before the war, Yudhishthira approached Bhishma Pitamaha and he did namaskar to him. And he said, this war is about to begin. You please bless me that I become victorious. He said, yes, Yashashvi Bhava, Vijayi Bhava. He said, you will... Because wherever there is dharma, there alone lies victory. So in this way, Bhishma Pitamaha was very well revered person, a very elderly, very revered person. And Dronacharya also, Arjuna's teacher, who had favored Arjuna in many ways, and who had taken given him a promise that I will make you the greatest archer in the world. And he had also great regard for Arjuna. So when the chariot was brought right in front of Bhishma Pitamaha and Dronacharya, Arjuna started all his emotions in his mind, and different types of feelings started coming in front of his mind. It's like a great surgeon who has done so many operations and all, and expert. His hands do not shake and all. And then he is about to operate a simple operation which he has done so many times. And just before he is to begin the operation, he notices that he is my own son who has been brought there emergency. And when his hands start shivering and all different types of emotions come. Because the ego gets shifted. From a surgeon, he becomes a parent. Then as a parent, when he's looking, it is different. Parent is not one who knows how to operate. Surgeon knows how to operate. But when he looks at as a parent, and he cannot operate then. Similarly, Arjuna had come here as a warrior, safeguarding dharma. But when he looked, he saw everyone with a different vision. That person who saw was not a warrior. He did not want to fight this war. He had a different vision altogether. So there was a mix-up of all these personalities, and total confusion happened. And that happens in our life also. Sometimes we don't know which personality is playing a role in our life, at what time. Some people mix up. At home, they are officers. In the office, they behave like a parent. And somewhere else, they behave someone else. So it becomes quite confusing. One person came late to the office. He says, "What happened? Why are you late?" He said, "No, I overslept." He said, "You sleep at home also? You sleep so much here." So all confusion can happen when we don't know our own personality, our own nature. So that confusion happens. So here when Bhagavan took the chariot in front of Bhishma and Dronacharya, and Sarveshancha Mahikshitan, and all other great warriors and the leaders and the kings of this earth, he brought the chariot in front of them, and Uvacha, here Sanjay says Uvacha, this is Bhagavan Uvacha. But he separately doesn't mention Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, which he mentions later on from the second chapter onwards. But here, just Uvacha, because casually Bhagavan had spoken here. So Sanjay also keeps it casual only. He doesn't give a separate place for that as Sri Bhagavan Uvacha. So Bhagavan spoke here. These are the only words which Bhagavan has spoken. The first word which Bhagavan uttered is Partha. He says Partha is to address Arjuna as Partha. Partha means Pritha's son. Kunti was also called Pritha. Therefore Arjuna was called Partha. Another name for Arjuna was Kaunteya, because Kunti. So he was always referred through as a son of Kunti. Bhagavan had great regard and affection for Kunti also. She had a great personality and a great devotee of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. So he was addressed as Partha. Hey Partha, Pasya. Again Bhagavan uses this term Pasya. See, look. You want to see? Look. Pasya. Whom? Etan samavetan kurun. The Kauravas who have assembled here. You look at them. See, generally this term Kauravas we save only for the Dhritarashtra's children and all. But even Pandavas were Kauravas. Pandavas were Kauravas means the same ancestry. Kurus. They were Kuru Vamshi. So here Bhagavan must have referred to both of them. Look at this Kauravas. Look at your cousins. Look at your own brothers. Look at all these great warriors who have assembled here. You wanted to see, you see. Pasya etan samavetan kurun iti. So these are beautiful words of Bhagavan. Bhagavan shows us. And if we don't have the proper vision, we get confused. See, our vision is given to us by our wisdom. Our knowledge, our wisdom gives us vision, how to see. See, even if suppose there is a music program, and if I don't know how to hear, of course I know how to hear, you may say, kaan to hai, Bhagwan ne diya hua hai, suno. But you will hear only sound. But when I have the wisdom of the different ragas and all, I will be able to hear much more than what the ears only can hear. You understand? Much more. There are some rasikas, some what you call the premis of this music and all, they can notice, they can appreciate every nuance of that music. Others, sab theek hai. Ye raag hai, wo raag hai. Ki farak penda. Theek hai. Like modern art, you know. Haan, theek hai. One fellow went to that modern art gallery and criticizing, what type of portrait is this? Such silly looking fellow you have drawn in. What is it? He says, sorry, this is not a portrait, it's a mirror here. So this requires special knowledge to see, to hear, to taste, to touch. These are simple, these senses are, even animals, they have senses. Dogs also can see the same tree or same image which human being can see. But a lot of difference. When they are watching with their masters the serial and all, they don't get affected. But they get affected. So much so that they forget to feed the dog. So the senses remaining same, the images which are outside conveys much more or much less or different things depending on the wisdom which I have. Wisdom makes a lot of difference. Like the earth remaining same, the earth was seen differently in different ages. In the development of science, in the beginning they felt that earth is like flat. And earth is at the center of the whole universe, everything is moving around the earth. Then they came to know that no, earth is not flat, it is spherical, and it is not at the center. It is also at the side. There are a lot of other planets. In this way, as our wisdom grows, the way we look at the world also changes. Also our relationship depends on our wisdom. What is our wisdom? So here Bhagavan is showing us that Arjuna saw and he got confused, he got deluded, he got, he became unhappy. Why? Not because his eyes were defective, but his wisdom was defective. The situation remaining same, how we look, is what will determine the whole thing. So therefore Bhagavan wanted to bring out this point. Okay, you want to see? You see. Let me see how you see. So pashya etan samavetan kuruniti. You look at these Kauravas who have assembled here. Then Sanjay continues, he says, Tatra pashyastitan partha. Tatra pashyastitan partha. Pitrunatha pitamahan. Acharyan matulan bhratrin. Putran pautran sakinstatha. Shvashuran suhrdashchaiva. Sena yorubhayorapi. Tan samikshasa kaunteyah. Sarvan bandhun avasthitan. Kripaya paraya vishtah. Vishedan nidam abravit. Tatra pashyat sthitan parthah. Pitrunatha pitamahan. Acharyan matulan bhratrin, putran pautran sakinstatha, shvashuran. Sanjay is describing. Sanjay could not only see what is happening in the battlefield, but he could also understand what is happening in the minds of people. He could know from what standpoint Arjuna is looking at this army, how he was looking. He could see, he could understand. He said, Tatra pashyat stitan parthah pitrun atha pitamahan. So what did Arjuna see? He says, Tatra apashyat, he saw stitan there, assembled there, parthah, Arjuna, he saw pitrun, people of his father's age. Fathers means of the age of his fathers, on both the sides. Then Pitamahan, Bhishma Pitamaha, as well as others who were of that age. Then Acharyan, teachers. Dronacharya was there. Then Kripacharya was there. Even Bhishma Pitamaha was like a teacher. Then Matulan, maternal uncles. Bhratrun, brothers from his own side, and then cousins, he saw them. Then Putran, his own son, as well as sons and of that age, all of that age, his son's age. Then Pautran, grandsons of children of that age also, all of them. See, almost some 7 generations were fighting. Bhishma Pitamaha, though he was the eldest, but even elder than him was, his uncle was also there. His, Shantanu's brother was also there. People used to live for a long time. Therefore, whenever they felt like dying, they used to maybe go for a war. So, they used to live for a long time. So, Shantanu's brother, then Bhishma Pitamaha. Bhishma Pitamaha himself was quite elderly because Shantanu's children were like Bhishma Pitamaha's children only, that age. So then there were people of that age also. Then Dhritarashtra of that age, who were father for Arjuna. Then Arjuna's age. Then Arjuna's children's age, then Arjuna's grandchildren's age. Even Parikshit, who was in the womb of Uttara, Arjuna's grandchild, he was also involved in the war. Not directly, indirectly. Because after the war, Ashwatthama, he sent a missile, Brahmastra, as though into the womb of Uttara to kill this fetus. And in order to protect him, protect that unborn Parikshit, Bhagwan entered her womb and protected him. So all the 7 generations were involved in this war. From his own family, then from the mother's side, then father's side, then all his friends, sakhins, all friend circles, then Shwashuran, fathers-in-law, then Suhrudashchaiva. Suhrud means well-wishers. Well-wishers were also involved. Senayor Ubhayorapi, in both the senas. See, again, I am saying that how we look at the world, it depends on our wisdom. And as we look, those type of emotions come. Those type of thoughts come. Therefore, later on we will see in the 6th chapter also, Bhagavan talks about meditation. He says that you brahmachari vrate sthitaha, when you sit for meditation, you sit with the intention of relating only to that Brahma, as a seeker of Brahma. when we are meditating on God, we should only keep this relationship of a devotee and Bhagwan. If we are sitting as a father, as a mother, as a brother, as a sister, as a neighbor, for other people around, their thoughts will come. We will not be able to meditate on Bhagwan. Because our thoughts are related to what we consider ourselves to be at our particular point. What is our personality? What is our attitude? What is our understanding about myself at a particular point will determine the type of thoughts and emotions which come. Therefore, that day also I think I must have told in the last yajna about Hanumanji when he went to Lanka. Ravan asked him that, "Who are you? Oh my dear, not my dear, but oh my bandar, not my bandar also, but oh monkey, who are you?" So Hanumanji said that, you know, the one who created this world, now see, there is no connection, the one who created this world, the creator of this world, by whose strength, by whose little strength you have also gained greatness in this world, I am the servant of that creator. I am the sevak of that creator. That was his self-view. That is how he looked at himself. Therefore, all thoughts, all emotions will be tuned with this view only. Many times what happens, we try to suppress our emotions, we try to change them, we try to change our thoughts. But what is important is change the way you are looking at yourself. Change the way your view about yourself is. Also transform the way what view you have about the world and also about God. Our self-view, world-view and God-view determines the type of emotions and type of thoughts which come into us. If we look at God also as someone who is out there to punish me, to always trouble me, Bhagwan, mere piche kyun pade huye ho? You are giving everything to others, not to me. You are always like that. If that view is there, then everywhere we will see that some trouble coming to our life. If we look at this world as our enemy, then world also seems to be behaving like that. So it's very important how, with what vision I'm looking. Here Arjuna was not looking as a Kshatriya. He was not looking as a person who has come here to defend dharma. He had changed his vision. When he saw Bhishma Pitamaha, he looked at himself as his child. When he looked at Dronacharya, he looked at himself as his shishya. When he looked at other people there, he looked at them as his brother, his fathers, his grandfathers, his children, his cousins. He just related with them as this. Therefore, there is a very beautiful image which we have of justice also, no? That lady holding that tarazu, blindfolded. Because the importance is not what you are, you should not get colored by your vision. So you should give a balanced judgment. Just because they are your friends or their neighbors, you should not be partial. The judgment should be impartial. Should look at everyone in the same way. Sarva dharma samabhav, sarva jana samabhav. Look at everyone in the same way and give that justice. But if we change our vision, then our emotions also come according to that vision. So here Arjuna saw his own relatives, his friends and all, Shwashuran, fathers-in-law, Surudashchaiva, his well-wishers, Senayor, Ubhayor Madhe, in both the Senas. And Tan Samikshasa Kaunteyaha, and having not only seen but having observed. See, one is we see, but we see in various ways. One is we see in the present moment. but we also see in future also. For example, suppose you are having, let us say, some food, you are eating. We are just looking at it. Some gulab jamun is there, first class, soft, garam, acha. So you are seeing with your eyes that nice gulab jamun and you are about to eat it. Then someone says that, oh, don't eat, please, it is usme kuch poison gir gaya. It is poisonous. When that person says it is poisonous, you just don't look at it as a poisonous thing, but you go much ahead. You see that if I eat, I will die. You see up till your death. You just don't see it as poison. Are wah poisonous hai, taste karke dekhta hun. Nay, you see your death also. Means you see much ahead. So here also, when Arjuna looked, he just did not look with his eyes, but he looked much ahead. Because he looked at them as his relatives. So Kaunteya sarvan bandhun. Bandhun, his relatives he saw. He did not see them as an army. He did not see them as an opposite adharmic army with whom he had to fight to restore dharma. But he saw them as his bandhun. See, all this vision are appropriate in appropriate time. That is very important. Many people, they misunderstand this first chapter, cannot be analyzed properly. We have to look, like when we are at home in a different situation, we should look at our relatives as our relatives. But when we have other role to play, we can't bring this relative business in that. We can't say, no, he's my relative, usko chhod do. All corruption happens because of that only. He crossed the red light, chalo usko saza do. Nahi, wo mera friend hai, usko chhod do. So why friend ko can do adharma and others you should punish and all? So all this type of faulty vision comes when we don't know how to look, what role to play, at what time. So here Arjuna, at the wrong place in the battlefield, he changed his role. It became so difficult for Bhagavan Krishna actually. Just imagine, he's driving the chariot, later on Arjuna is saying all sorts of things. It must be so embarrassing for him. So he says, Tan samikshasa kaunteyaha sarvan bandhun avasthitan. What happened to Arjuna? Kripaya paraya vishtah. He was overpowered. Paraya. Supremely overpowered. By what? Kripa, kripaya, compassion. Compassion, kripa means compassion. Compassion by itself is good. But it should be at the right place, at the right time. That is very important. In the society, in our society also, people have great compassion and all. But at the wrong time, at the wrong place, with the wrong people, they show this type of compassion, which is not proper. Because everything has got its own place and time. Again, to give that example of that doctor who is about to operate and remove the appendix. Doctor has got great understanding about the human structure and all this thing and all. And they study it, all the different parts. And he opens the belly and he is about to remove the appendix. Kabhi kabhi kidney bhi nikal dete, lage hath. But appendix. And then suppose just before removing it, he suddenly is overpowered by compassion. This appendix, such simple, nice. It is also born with the same body. Usne kya guna kiya hai? Ki usko nikal ke hum pheke. It will die if you cut it and keep it outside, it will die. That appendix is also born in the same body. It also has got the same right at heart and kidneys and other organs. So why remove it? So if he has got this compassion and suppose the relative is also there and he tells कि मैं नहीं निकाल सकता हूँ इसको कैसे हो सकता है ऐसा इट विल बी सच अ डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन सो कंपैशन बाय इट्सेल्फ इट शुड नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड इट शुड बी अंडरस्टूड विद रिलेशन एंड सच मिस्टेक्स वी हैव डन इन अवर कंट्री ऑल्सो हिस्टोरिकल मिस्टेक्स वेरिन पीपल हैव शोन कंपैशन मिसप्लेस्ड कंपैशन to even aggressors who had come, who attacked our country, and we showed compassion, aur unko chhod diya. Phir se unhone attack kiya, phir se chhod diya. So it should be understood properly. Because many people have this faulty understanding. Even on, then they do this in the our news channel also. If somebody has committed crime, that person has to be punished according to the laws of the nation, they should be punished. But then they will show their wife, the children crying, then some neighbor coming, then to create such a feeling of compassion in everyone's heart. Then will say, everyone will say, oh ho, human right, usko chhod dena chahiye, bechara bhala aadmi hai. एक दो को मार दिया उसमें क्या लेट इट बी यू शुड शो कंपैशन कंपैशन इज द ग्रेटेस्ट इमोशन एंड दिस वन ग्रेट मास्टर्स दे हैड कंपैशन उसको छोड़ दो दे उसको छोड़ देते हैं बाद में और अत्याचार करता है सो देर आर दिस लॉज देर आर दिस फिलोसॉफी अबाउट क्राइम एंड पनिशमेंट एंड ऑल विच वन हैज़ टू फॉलो सिंसियरली We can't be, like even in our body, if the immune system goes away, then the body cannot survive. Even one virus can come and create havoc in the body system. You cannot remove the immune system of the body. Similarly, for example, the Sena, the warriors and all, are also part of the society. However much we may not like violence, but it is also part to defend a society that is also required. If that portion is eliminated, let us say if we decide, let us eliminate all the warriors, only other class of people can be there, it can create a lot of disturbance in the society. It is not possible. Maybe if one evolves to become totally dharmic, everyone, then one can think in a different way. But till then, this is not possible. If everything, whole vatavaran become absolutely sanitized, then I can remove all the immune system from my body. Then kahin par bhi jaake pani pee sakta hoon, kahin par gol gappe kha sakta hoon, kuch nahi hoga mereko. People come from abroad for a few time here, our own people. इतनी excitement होके गोलगप्पे खाते हैं और बीमार हो जाते हैं पहले वही गोलगप्पे खाते थे कुछ नहीं होता था उनको But after few months of stay abroad, when they come here, they fall sick because the system becomes weak and they can't then deal with this. So compassion, the word is used here, but it was Therefore, later on we will find in the second chapter, Bhagavan uses this same thing. He says that you have misplaced compassion. Compassion by itself is good, but misplaced. Anger also, if it is misplaced, it is bad. But if it is placed rightly, it is also good. Anger is also good. If suppose adharma is happening, but I don't feel anger, that is also bad. कुछ बुरा हो रहा है वन शुड हैव दैट फीलिंग दैट हाउ आई शुड डू समथिंग अबाउट इट इफ इट डजंट कम देन दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट प्रॉपर सो दिस वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज धर्म वॉट इज अधर्म एंड ऑल सो कृपया परया अविष्ट सो अर्जुन वॉज ओवर पावर्ड बाय कंपैशन वॉट कंपैशन ही मस्ट हैव सीन थ्रू हिज विजन What will happen during this war. People will die, lot of killing, lot of things will happen. And he felt great sense of compassion in his heart. So, Kurpaya Paraya Vishtaha Vishidan Nidama Bravid. With lot of Vishad, he was overpowered by Vishad. Vishad means grief. And with this grief and with this compassion in his heart, he spoke the following words. The following words are then now words of Arjuna. And from that we understand his mental condition. So let us see. Arjuna Vacha Drishtvemam Swajanam Krishna Yuyutsum Samupasthitam Sidanti Mamagatrani Mukhancha Parishushyati Vepatushcha Sharireme Roma Harshascha Jayate Drishtvemam Swajanam Krishna Yuyutsum Samupasthitam Arjuna Vach, Arjuna is speaking here. Again, from this we understand Arjuna's straightforward nature also, his integrated nature. Whatever was happening in his mind, whatever he was thinking, he was expressing very sincerely to Bhagavan Sri Krishna. And this also shows us the relationship which he had with Bhagavan Sri Krishna. He did not hide anything from him. He was very open and very sincere and genuine. And whatever he felt, he expressed. And that is one of the most important thing if we should have our relationship should be with Bhagavan or with our teacher also. And also they say with the doctor and all, if we try to hide something, then he will give us some other medicine. Similarly, with the teacher, we should be able to express our doubts or our situation properly so that he can resolve it. So here also, Bhagavan became the teacher of Arjuna, and Arjuna could express everything very sincerely. So he says, Drishtvevam Swajanam Krishna, Hey Krishna, seeing, having seen this, all these people, who? Swajanam, that word he uses. Swajanam means apne log. Aur koi log hote, to I would have fought. But apne log hai. Mere apne. Ne? Swajanam. He uses that word Swajanam many times. He is looking at the whole situation from a very personal standpoint. And here, the whole situation was not about personal. It was a dharmic thing. And a Raj Dharma and what you call Samaj Dharma and all was involved. For example, even nowadays in, let us say, some war is there happening, the soldiers and all cannot have their personal thing coming in between. कि मेरा रिलेटिव है फ्रेंड है दो ही इज़ फ्रॉम द अपोजिट कैंप तो उसको छोड़ देते हैं यू कैन नॉट शो पर्सनल एंगर आल्सो दैट इज़ आल्सो कंसिडर रॉन्ग सो यर ही लुक्ड एट एवरीवन एज स्वजनम दृष्ट्वे मम स्वजनम कृष्ण युयुत्सुम समुपस्थितम बट द होल थिंग वॉज सो कन्फ्यूजिंग माई ओन पीपल बट दे हैव कम टू फाइट विथ मी They have come to fight with me. Usually people, your family members and all come for some parties or some nice occasion and all. Here my own people are there standing in front of me, ready to fight. Yuyusum, eager to fight. We got to fight this battle. They have assembled samapasthitam. So seeing them, hey Krishna, the whole thing came to his mind. He no longer felt himself as a warrior. He was no longer a warrior there. He was no longer a kshatriya there. He was a son, he was a father, he was a grandson, and he was a shishya. All these roles came into him. And for all these roles, the whole situation was totally out of place. So he says, Sidanti mama gatrani. He started explaining what he was feeling. He says, all my limbs are becoming very weak. See, our physical body shows our inner emotions very, very interestingly many times. Okay? If I am angry, it shows on my face. Sometimes colors also, they talk about colors. Jealousy, what color?
Green.
Anger?
Red.
Aur kya hai?
Peace, white.
Different colors are there. So which comes on our expression comes. Actually, our physical body is directly it is directly under our sukshma sharir. A sukshma sharir itself expresses or directly connected to this physical body in a very intimate way. So when my mind changes, my body also changes. When my thinking changes, my body changes. My breathing changes. My digestion changes. My circulation of the blood changes. The way all the organs function, they change. If I am unhappy, the organs also become little sikud jate hai wahan par. If there is a feeling of, if there is anger, all the organs get affected. The heart gets affected, the kidneys get affected. So all of them are intimately connected to our emotions. Though I don't know about allopathy, but there are so many other systems which then like acupuncture and all, they talk about, even the channels they talk about as heart channel and stomach channel and kidney channel and spleen and all those things. So our emotions affects our body. It shows, like all the, we feel that our limbs and all are very strong, but if a negative emotion comes, suddenly they become weak. Our joints and all become weak when our mind becomes weak. So he says, Sidanti mama gatrani, my gatra, all my limbs are becoming very weak, they are failing, he says. Mukhancha parishushyati, the mouth has gone dry. Ghabraat se bhi ho jata hai. Even he had fear. See, Arjuna, before coming, he had his pride and all, but now he had fear also. He had unplaced compassion had come in his heart. He had confusion. He had sorrow, deep sorrow, what we call grief. He had already seen them dead. So he had this grief. So, Sidanti mama gatrani mukhancha parishushyati vepathushcha sharire me, and my whole limbs, all the body is shivering, shaking, shivering. Vepathushcha sharire me roma harshascha jayate, there is horripilation, all my hairs are standing on end. When you have extreme emotions, even fear, hairs stand on end. At night, on Amavasya night, alone, with some people alone means some are there who are telling you ghost stories, you will find the hair standing on end. Andheri raat, Amavasya ki, door kahin, wolf woo kar raha hai. Then this whole thing is. You start. Because you start relating, because that feeling comes, and whenever there is fear, The hair stand on end because the fear is to frighten. One is I am afraid because somebody is attacking me. So in order to frighten that, the hairs also stand on end so that I look more frightening for the other fellow. So all sorts of things happen in the body, and it's quite funny. So Roma Harshascha Jayate. Some more things he said that we will see tomorrow. Now we will just leave him with Roma Harsh. Okay.
Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om